So here's a lap of the Diamond Races course over on the Isle of Wight. Now we're heading now down the military road. Somewhere along this section we're hoping for the start finish to be put together. Now it's an incredible surface down here, it really is. It's kind of a big massive eye-opener, very high speed, kind of relative to the run from Port Stewart down to Port Rush at the Northwest 200, and especially like the mountain section of the Isle of Man. This will be flat in sixth gear for the majority of this just under 5 miles of military road before we head off into a more technical section. You can see the road surface here. You know, the island have got a great budget to keep on top of the road surface and keep it in tip-top order. This is pretty much brand new tarmac for the whole stretch of this road, it really is. Of course, there are many white lines on this section in the centre of the road that will have to be treated, and with the cat's eyes, they're glued down actually, but they'll have to be removed. Now, you'll be in the tuck again here. Obviously, we're keeping all of this coverage that you're watching at road legal speeds for obvious reasons. Look at these vehicles coming the other way. Now, of course, these hedgerows are going to be flicking past very quickly in race action. Now, you've got a real fast right-hand curve here, which I'm pretty sure will be flat chat under race pace into another very fast left. Of course, this section will be difficult to spectate at. These bikes have been doing 200 miles per hour down this particular section of road for so long. It will be an exhilarating part of the circuit that, of course, all the riders will certainly look forward to once they've finished all the technical section around the island. Now, the race is here. You can see there's some great views over there with the mountain. We're heading now towards the end of this military road section. It's all very fast flowing curves. Now you're approaching the last section here. We're going to go for a real fast left over a hilltop, stay left down the side of the road into a fourth gear fast downhill right section. Quite daunting and very blind until you get right over this crest just about here. Now you'll need to be on that white line, back down the gearbox, in and then back on the throttle before you get there. The camber's really great running out of here, and it'll enter to a great fast section of the last part of this military road. Now a long left kink here. The left hand side of the road has got a good positive camber, no problems. You're probably back to fourth gear running through this section. We're going to take a sharp left in a moment. This is the Chale area into Chale village, just past the church. Here we go. James is indicating he's keeping it all nice and legal, of course. No knee on the floor. A left turn, away we go. Now this is where the lap starts to get a little narrower. Of course, at race pace, it will be carrying quite a flow down here. The garage, obviously, on the left-hand side will be closed for the racing and practice days, of course, for the Diamond Races. Now, I know it's a little bit difficult to see some of this, but it's quite undulated. We're running down a hill now into a blind left, but actually, it'll be quite fast under race pace. Not a lot of runoff area, of course, but some great hedgerows, which will help, of course, to see the direction of the corner and where it's going for a rider, especially when they're learning, and to get a good run through this section. Now, plenty of stone walls all the way around this course. Of course, they will be protected by ply boards to stop dragging the riders from their machines if they do happen to touch their elbow. All of those manhole covers you can see will be treated. Again, we've got a section, kind of a blind hilltop just here. All of these places are going to be so hard to get at one with for all of our riders that are expected for the races in 2021, next October. Now, another downhill section. I've said already, it's quite undulated. You know, there's a crown in the middle of the road, so they will have to learn the circuit, and not just where the corners go, but the nature of the course, to where it drains, where the cambers are, where it's positive, where it's negative. Quite a difficult task, of course, for anybody, and especially being 12.4 miles long of the whole circuit. Again, you can see the white lines passing these bungalows, houses, and some of the farmyards. You know, it will be considerably quicker, obviously, at race pace. We're running through into the left here, past an old chapel, another stone wall, which again will be boarded. I'm guessing this is probably third gear running through this. There's still quite some speed, probably 100 mile an hour running through this tight section, where again it'll open up in a second out into a much faster, wider visual point running down towards our next left turn. It's going to be a great place here for obviously all the locals to spectate, as well as people that are visiting the Isle of Wight. You know, it has some good places, some nice big high banks next to parts of this lap where you can go and sit up and of course have a picnic or a brew, and of course watch the bikes fly by. This is where it opens up a little bit. We're going to head down to, you'll see a phone box on the right hand side. We're going to turn left there, and believe me, it gets even more technical for this part. This is another great spectating area on the left hand side. The first few metres of course will be prohibited, but the back side we will be allowing spectators down there. We're going to take a left turn now. Hopefully James Hillier here will indicate. That's lovely, just past the bus stop. We're going to take a left at the junction. Now we've got a slight right kink here up and over where the stone wall is on the left hand side. We've got kind of a, let's call it a three apex right hander, quite a technical part of the track in all fairness, which is completely blind to learn, but quite exhilarating when you're doing it. You're going up and over a crest and downhill, and then you run through the last part of the corner just here and out onto a short straight up this section. Again, it looks quite narrow here. It is this, when this is filmed, it is the part of the year where all the hedgerows and grass bushes are very overgrown, so it will look narrow of course for the race and practice week. However, it still comes up very quickly. We've got a sharp right here. If you go straight on there, that's the local motocross track. Well, you'll be back up to top gear running through this section. Okay, you're running out of Chale Green Village there, down through a fast section which is all very curvy. You go right, left, right, and then left again before we're going to turn off left. Now of course quite a few telegraph poles on the right hand side, they'll always be protected of course in active conditions when the roads are closed. There's a good spectating areas down here where you can get high up and see the bikes coming for quite some way away. Now these are all fast curves. I know it's a tight section, but we're going to turn left just after these telegraph poles each side of the road, just now, a left turn. Again, it tightens up as you get in, so you will have to be accurate here. It's a great camber until you cross over the white line, then it goes a little bit negative. We're heading downhill now. And this next section, we're going to run through some trees. We've got to do some work just through here, just to make sure the runoff area is nice and safe. There is a steel fencing system there. We'll probably board it all the way through and take the fence down in all fairness. As you can see, it's quite banked. It's little like it's a little bit like the dip on the last part of the TT lap before you come out into the Glen Country Road. But it opens up once again. You're flying through some fast curves now, a long left here, a fast right kink. Again, this will get faster and faster, and of course our riders are going to be learning, not just for the first year, but for the first few of course, getting faster and faster each year. A long curve here, no sharp corners as such just yet, only the left where we turned off at the church in Chale. This is all we're building now. We're getting higher and higher, heading uphill, so it'll be really important here to keep the bike flowing, a little bit like over the mountain section of the TT. We're working our way up to the crest of the hill, which is a big farm on the left hand side. I can't remember what it's called. But just as we come over the crest, there's a big long fence, here we go, on the left hand side. All those fence posts will be coming out and will be plugged when we're running back downhill. What a great spectating area. Look, if you can get far back on the hillside there, you can see these bikes coming from a long way away. Good camber there, a good surface all the way around this lap. The surface is fabulous, it really is. There's no potholes at all, no issues, no lines in the road. It's a great surface and is very well maintained. Up and over the crest, we've got a farm on the right hand side. We're going to move this white fence back of course for action. Running through a long curve now, we're going to build back uphill, up a long curve and into a quite a sharpish right hander at the top. I'm guessing it will probably be third gear. You run more speed through here than what you think once the roads are closed of course. Now running along a hilltop now, quite a long straight in all fairness. You will get up back up to fifth or sixth gear of course on the super bikes when they do arrive. And then you got to run over this crest, quite a daunting section where it seems to tighten all the way, or you'll be over the O in slow and running into Shorwell just down the hill. Now it seems to be very narrow here, but it is kind of one line in all fairness, and quite they're fast curves, We've got a left now, then a short straight. We're going to head into probably a second gear right-hand turn, which tightens up right at the end. We're very, very late apex. All of this section, of course, will be manned with marshals with viewing points to the next marshalling section. Here we go. Here's the second gear right hand I was talking about. Plenty of runoff straight on if you run into any issues or problems. Quite a late apex. We can't show it now, of course, because it's the roads are open. A late apex to run through this section. Then a long left curve. We've got a great section coming up shortly. Now, all of this is blind, of course. You're running past all of these houses, which are all going to be roped off, fenced off, driveways and things running through this section. There's good camber through that left. Now, there's a few manholes that I've already mentioned. They'll all be treated, of course. Gary Thompson's been doing a great job so far. We're just running down past that junction to a sharp left now. Of course, the road will be blocked off from the right. We've got a right flick here. We've got an issue with a few ducks crossing the road here quite a few times we've been over. We'll have to look at that. Changing back up the gearbox, probably up to third, fourth gear now. Quite a steep climb, so you'll have to be really important there to get back on the gas early to carry the speed up and over the hill once you start to get near a lap time and get through to qualifying. And especially, of course, some race pace. We're following the car now. Fortunately, we're on a 40 mile an hour limit, of course, out of 30 into the 40. This is a lovely, lovely blind left curve. There's a great spectating there on the left over the hedge where you can see the bikes coming all the way out of the village and up the hill and over, and watch them peel through the fast left and into a sharpish third gear, I would say right-hander, and then disappear into the distance. A great spectacle along that wooden fence on the left. So you'll be back to third gear here. It's kind of a 90 bend, but probably I would say second or third gear realistically. In there's a manhole, there's a marker on the footpath. Back on the gas at that, pushing yourself out, getting up some good speed again. You're going to come over the hilltop. There's quite a good section coming up now. You know, it's a 40 limit, of course, for these vehicles that we're following. But of course, it's going to go from right to left to right to left. It's a great, great section. It's going to take some reading. You've got some height on over. You can see the coastline there in the distance as we come over the hedge top. But a great section just here. Now, we've got a left curve there. This is going to be pretty high speed at the moment. It really is. You know, we're coming through a complex of curves, shall we say. And then we're going to go into a real fast left and a right. But this is going to take some learning. It's all undulated, like I keep saying. We're passing the car here. Okay, we're going to go past. We've got a sharp left coming up. A nice little thank you to our local car driver. Okay, the braking area will be coming up very shortly as you pass this sign, past this cottage. And of course, you've got a cottage in front of you in the braking area. Now, it's a sharp left. This will all be blanked off with rectocell, of course. A second gear left-hander and a second gear right-hander, where we're going to obviously be a little bit careful. We're going to take the fence posts out on the left, make sure they're all plugged to keep everything nice and safe if we do have an issue. We're climbing again now. We've got a fast left curve into a fast right curve. A few houses coming up on the right-hand side. The camber of the road is very kind to you, and as I've said already, the surface is fabulous for the whole lap. I don't really need to mention that. It's incredible. That'll be a big wheelie point there where you'll be desperate to get the front wheel back down to get the bike to turn through these curves, controlling it with the back brake, of course. Passing some houses here, you've got a long right curve as you're on the bike, running over the hilltop. Now, we're about to run into this section now with another left-right situation, but quite a lot faster, where you'll carry a lot of speed into the corner, but with a great camber. There are some manholes there on the road, but they'll be far enough offline, I believe, to keep the riders nice and safe, even though they will be treated. Here we go. We're running right down the hill, over the slow sign, back into third gear here. We're back to the 30 limit, of course. There's a manhole there on the right. We'll be just underneath that on the line. Back on the gas early. We've got a real sharp right-hander that tightens up now. It'll be very hard to get on the power here early because it'll push you wide into the hedge if you're not careful. So where that manhole is in the right, back on the gas there. Accelerate out hard. At the end of this church wall, we're going to turn left any second. We really are. So we're braking hard now. Back to second gear. Boom. Second or even first possibly. A sharp left turn. Short shift. Second, first, second, third if you're in first. Into a long downhill right curve. Now we have to be careful through here. There is a school in this area, but it's a negative camber on the left hand side of the road, so you'll be trying to miss that as much as possible at race pace so you can get as much drive out of that section. A big long section, a big straight section here. This is what I call the link road, which is taking us back up to the military road, that real fast part where we started up from. Now you can see, I like leading James Hillier, I really do. Now we're running down this last link road. It's going to be really quick, and it leads you into quite a, over a crest, into a quite a fast right and a left. You climb back up and over a crest of a rise. Quite an exhilarating circuit, in all fairness. Here we're back now on the left, back on the gas, accelerating hard. Mind that negative camber up and over the rise. You're going to be back in the bubble now, probably up to fourth gear, maybe even fifth, to keep the bike nice and settled. As you go through this left curve, there's a sharp right coming up into a really sharp, which will be a left 180 hairpin to bring you back onto the military road. So here we go, through the left. You can see on the signpost there, we're going to go right. Okay, we can't have any spectators in on the left for obvious reason. Into a long, long left 180. Here we go with a very late apex. Of course, we've got to stop here because it's a junction back onto that fabulous military road. We'll pull out of here, second gear. Second, third, fourth. Run through this the brick walls on the bridge into a real fast right-hand curve. Now, you'll be desperate to come powering out of here on a real positive camber. It's fabulous. Look at the surface. Look how smooth it is. It's better than the M25 motorway. It really is. Back up to top gear in the bubble. And this is where it starts to get really adrenaline pumped and full of excitement. You'll be flat out down this section for a long time. Don't forget, this is going to be a time trial. So we are hoping, especially for year one, the riders are going to be quite spaced out, with no worries of course, getting tangled up with anybody else. But if you do get caught with somebody, there's going to be a massive slipstream. There really is. You flat out all the way from those brick walls where we just mentioned and come through there for such a long time. This section of road is 4.9 miles long, and is going to be so exciting. It really is. It will give you a chance to relax slightly. However, there's some real high-speed, fast curves. You can see this hilltop coming up. This is going to be incredible. It really is. You'll be flat over that hilltop in sixth gear. You should just be able to make it, I would say. I am guessing, of course, because I've never been that fast down this road. But, of course, you'll be covering the back brake. And I'm hoping that will be visual from our finish line and our corporate hospitality and the paddock for the end of each of the races, or for every lap, of course. So we're running down here. Of course, you can see in the distance there the white cliffs. Beautiful view, very scenic. The sea on the left-hand side there. Look over this crest. Okay, there's a little kink in the road, but when you come down, what a fabulous bit of kit. There you go. Come, just roll down the hill. Another fast right curve again. That'll be flat out. It really will. Of course, we're not showing the true speed at the moment. We're being good boys and using our heads. Over this crest, you'll be covering the back brake, and I'm hoping the hospitality and the paddock will be down there on the right-hand side. That's yet to be confirmed, but that's where our favourite place. You can see the coast there on the right-hand side. This is going to be a great spectacle and a fabulous place for all spectators to come and watch and to see at high speeds these boys buzzing down here on these 1000cc superbikes, of course. And putting on a great show. That's it, guys. That's the end of our lap. Sorry if I've waffled on a little bit, but I just wanted to give you a great insight into the Diamond Races course.